regular ChatGPT is like having this overqualified friend that could probably run NASA. But all you really needed to do is come up with the right Instagram captions for your intended audience. That's how I went down the GPT rabbit hole. I'm about to show you how to do this in less than 30 minutes. And no coding skills required. Let's roll. In terms of the requirements, you will need a ChatGPT Plus subscription. Before we get started, let's talk strategy. Any GPT worth building uses what I call the 3P GPT framework, which is purpose, persona, and process. Purpose. So the purpose isn't just about having a helpful marketing assistant. We need to get very hyper-specific, like creating scroll-stopping social media posts. Now for the second P, persona. This is where you really want to make sure that you're reflecting the right expertise and the right tone. Do you want it to be professional but still playful? Do you want it to sound like Beyonce? You want to make sure that as the casting director, you are casting the right actor that has the right tone and the right voice to reflect the GPT that you're building. Now, in terms of process, this is where you want to build in the process that you would use for this specific purpose. Like before giving any recommendations, you want to make sure that the GPT asks three clarifying questions. Do you want to make sure that as the GPT responds to inquiries, that it's always giving two relevant examples? That 3P blueprint is going to be foundational to how useful and effective your GPT will be. Let's head on over to chatgpt.openai.com. Once you sign in, you'll see in the left panel, there is a GPT section. You'll click on that and you'll come across what looks like an app store of GPTs. You can try out any of these GPTs. You can even see what's trending. Today, we're gonna create our own by clicking the black create button on the top right. This is your blank canvas moment. You have two options here. You can either build the GPT through conversations with ChatGPT, or you can have full control through the configure tab. We're gonna be on control mode today and click on the configure mode. For this tutorial, we're going to create Persona Pro, the expert marketer's persona builder that any business could benefit from. My goal here is to combine strategic questioning, deep research logic, and proven frameworks to build personas that actually work. Let's fill out the basics. This is your elevator pitch moment. This is where folks will decide if they're gonna give your GPT a chance. Make sure that you create something compelling. In terms of the name of this GPT, it's going to be called Persona Pro. It's short, it's memorable, and it tells you exactly what it does. As for the description, hi, I'm Persona Pro, your strategist for building advanced customer personas. I'll start by asking a few questions to learn what you already know about your audience. Then I'll run a simulated market scan and use both to build out high quality personas ready for your marketing, sales, or product teams. Shall we begin? Notice how it's not just describing the features, but it's really painting a picture of what that experience is going to be like. Now for the instructions. I'm going to go super detailed here. This matters because that's how this becomes truly indispensable for your specific use case. That is also where I would add in the tone, the personality. You don't want to just say, be helpful. You want to be specific on the type of language and the type of tone that your GPT should have. So should it be witty? Should it be funny? Should it be visual? Should it provide a lot of stories? Maybe your GPT has a thing for metaphors. You want to get hyper specific here. This is what I'm going to give Persona Pro. Speak like a strategic consultant. Clear, confident, and slightly conversational. Use precise marketing language. Include examples when helpful. And guide users step by step. Be proactive in asking clarifying questions when details are missing. Each output should feel like a high quality deliverable or a ready to use asset. Act like a collaborator, not just a generator. Now, here's the real genius part. I'm going to give it a job and a process. In terms of the job, I'm going to say guide users through building advanced customer personas, and then I'm going to give it three instructions. Ask smart, strategic discovery questions, uncover insights through simulated market scans, create high quality personas using established marketing frameworks. Then I tell it for each persona exactly what I wanted to build. Name and title, demographics and firmographics, psychographics, behavioral triggers, pain points and objections, buyer journey insights, preferred channels and influencers, messaging hooks, emotional appeals, and an adoption readiness scores. A I'll layer in that I also wanted to build a jobs to be done framework for each of the personas. I've structured the persona pro with a 3-stage flow. This is replicating how any consultant would approach this project. Step one is strategic discovery. Determine what the user already knows and try to ask strategic questions to help build on that. Step two, simulated market scans. Generate insights based on real-world patterns, things that the GPT may discover from LinkedIn trends, Reddit boards, or even reviews. Step three, combine the user input and the simulated market scan to build the most actionable personas. Step three, the actual persona construction. So combine what you've learned from the user input as well as the simulated market scans and build a complete, super actionable persona. Now for the next step, conversation starters. These are like questions that someone could use when they first meet your GPT. Make them intriguing and let the audience get an idea of how they can start the conversation. You can add in quite a few. Every time you start to type in one, a new entry box appears so that you can add additional options. Here's a few that I'm going to add in. Next step, upload any supporting files that you think the GPT would benefit from. So if you've got frameworks or brand guidelines that you want to upload, you can add those here. Another section is capabilities, and this is where you can get really fancy. You can toggle on DALL for image generation, code interpreter for data heavy tasks, or even web search so that you could be as current as possible with your responses. The next section is actions. This is where things get really exciting. You can connect your GPT through APIs to other services so that it can actually take actions in the real world for you. Imagine Persona Pro pulling in your CRM data or your recent support tickets, even posting any insights to your Slack channel. To set this up, click Create Action, choose your authentication, API key is usually easiest, and add the OpenAPI schema that tells your GPT how to communicate with external services. This is advanced territory, but the payoff can be huge. So now, to give your GPT a face, click the circle at the top to either have DALL create an image for you, or you can upload your own. I ended up uploading one of my own. Click that black create button on the top right and get ready to publish your creation. Here you get to decide who gets to see your creation. You could keep it to yourself, or you can make sure that anybody with the link could use it, or you can make it publicly available through the GPT store. You can even decide to toggle whether others are able to see your instructions. Yay! Check out that green light, our GPT is published. Now for the fun part. Let's test out our creation by using prompts that real users would use. And if something doesn't feel right, you can always go back into the instructions and make any tweaks necessary. Let's try this conversation for solo entrepreneurs with a coaching business that I had set up before. Right away, it has asked me some strategic questions. I'll play pretend and answer some of these. Once it received my responses, it started on step two, which was a simulated market scan. Lots of insights that'll be super helpful in building that final persona. And just like that, it's moving into step three and delivering a super tactical persona. Just for fun, I'm also going to ask it to create persona B. Here's the final Notion table and a chart featuring the two personas. If you click on the name of your GPT at the very top, it will also give you a slew of actions, including if you wanna edit your GPT, if you wanna start a new conversation with your GPT, but most importantly, if you'd like a link to be able to share it with others, you can also access it here. Here's a cool trick. In any ChatGPT conversation, you can add the name of your GPT to be able to use your GPT. You can also add the name of multiple GPTs to combine them. Here's a quick recap. The lightning round version of everything we've covered. Step one, strategy first, the 3P blueprint, purpose, persona, and process. Step two, head over to ChatGPT and set up the name and description. That's super compelling and encourages people to use your GPT. Step three, tone and behavior. You want to make sure that your GPT reflects your brand personality. Step four, build the brain with a clear identity, process, and methodology. Step five, conversation starters. Use irresistible prompts here to show the audience exactly what's possible. Step six, your secret sauce. Any guidelines, any frameworks, any files that will help support the process, you want to add those here. Step seven, your superpowers. Do you want it to generate images? Do you want it it to search the web, if you want it to be really good with data, this is where you want to turn those capabilities on. Step 7. This is where you can add the code interpreter, DALL for image generation, and you can turn on web browsing. Step 8. Connected to a world of services using APIs. This part is completely optional. You're in Step 9, give it a face. Upload your own image or have DALL generate it for you. Then, step 10, this is where you publish it, decide your audience, and get a chance to test and tweak. That's it. 10 steps between you and your AI agent. It should only take you about 20 to 30 minutes. And there you have it, your very own custom GPT that solves real-world problems. If this sparked something for you, we've got tons of AI-related content. So hit that subscribe button, give me a like, let me know what you thought about this video in the comments below. Till then, I'll see you in the next video.